Each year we remember them, the men and women of our fighting services who gave their all for our freedom. And each year by the cenotaph in London's Whitehall, those for whom they died gather to honor their memory and to pray that their great sacrifice was not in vain. The nation's leaders are here, and with them, the wounded of two world wars. Now, Her Majesty the Queen, clothed in somber black, arrives to pay royal homage to the fallen. Behind her come the two dukes, Edinburgh and Gloucester. The hour of 11 has struck. The Queen and her people throughout the land are hushed. And we remember. The ladies of the royal family watch as Her Majesty steps forward to place a wreath of red poppies in memory of her subjects who have died and are still dying for Britain. Now, in naval uniform, the Duke of Edinburgh pays his tribute, his mind perhaps turned to the men who fought and died alongside him in action at sea. The wreaths clustered at the foot of the cenotaph proclaim that we have not forgotten their sacrifice. There they lie, mute tributes to those who have found eternal rest. The ceremony of remembrance draws to its close, and the veterans of two world wars march past. But remembrance is not enough. Each day we must renew our pledge to forge a better world, a debt we owe our glorious dead.